It's time for a quick comparison. Which one looks better, the raw time-lapse photos straight from the GoPro, or taking those same photos and running them through Lightroom and Premiere Pro? If you're interested on how to do the latter, stay tuned. What's up there, YouTube fam? Javier Mercedes back at it again. Premiere Pro tutorial for you, man. GoPro time-lapse short flow, that's the plan. So please subscribe if you're into that, and smash that like button, don't hold back. Let's head to the computer, it's a Mac, and that is the end of my YouTube rap. All right, so once you pull the time-lapse off the SD card into the computer, it looks something like this. In your Finder, what I like to do, instead of having all of these just labeled GoPro random number, highlight all of them, right-click, we're gonna rename, and I'm just gonna format. And I'm gonna call this time-lapse dash there. So name and index, start numbers at one. So it's gonna take all these, and now I know that I have 549. This is much easier for me to read than the GoPro randomness. And also, if you're recording a lot of time lapses, this helps you organize and archive those time lapses. In order to start, we're gonna drag these into Lightroom. Boom. Now, right off the bat, Lightroom says, hey, I saw that you dragged that one file in. Here's the rest of these photos in this folder. Would you like to drag all of those? Why, yes, I'm gonna hit check all. Then I'm going to go to import. The reason I like using Lightroom is because the coloring with photos, especially raw photos, is much better, and you just have more control than in just Premiere using Lumetri. Click on this first one. Looks like a GoPro shot here, but because we're inside Lightroom, I'm gonna hit auto, and boom, look at that. Already, there's just more just information there. Now, there's a whole bunch of stuff that you can do within Lightroom, and there's a whole bunch of tutorials, like one that I made right here. Boop! I'm just gonna do a couple things here, and your situation is gonna be different than mine. Because we're outside, I like adding maybe clarity, and clarity is not something that you can really get inside Premiere, which is nice to have within Lightroom. And vibrance, look at the difference right there. Something like this. Here is how it was before, and here it is now. Way different. Once you have your first photo set, grab your first photo, highlight it, and then go scroll to the end of all of the photos, hold shift, click the very last one, and then hit sync. Now this dialog box that pops up is everything that you have done, and it's saying, hey, do you want to sync and copy over all of the exposure and everything else that you touched up? And I'm like, yes, everything that I did in this photo, I want it to go to every single photo. So I'm gonna hit synchronize and we'll see how it ends up. Yeah, just look at all that detail that you get in the clouds, and you don't really get that over here. I mean, I know it looks kind of fake, but whatever. I think it's cool. Just for this tutorial's sake, I'm good with that.
So again, select all of your shots from the first to the last, and make sure that the computer has had time to sync all of your changes to every single photo before you export.
Looks like it's done its thing. So now we go up to File, Export. Right here in the file settings, I'm just gonna go to JPEG. You could go to PNG if you wanted to, but JPEGs are smaller for me, and I'm just gonna do quality 100, and I'm not gonna resize to fit. I'm going to keep them the same scale that they are, and you'll see why here in a second. Export, and it's gonna ask me where to put them. And now I'm gonna call this new folder Edited JPEGs. All right, and once all those files are done exporting, open up Premiere, and go over here to our project bin. I'm going to go to Import. Find those files, Edit JPEGs, select the first photo, hit Options, Image Sequence, Import. It creates a time lapse inside Premiere. Right here, it's telling me that it's going to be 30 photos per second. So when I drop this in, my sequence isn't at 1920 by 1080. It is actually at this 4x3, which is okay. So at this point, I have a 4x3 time lapse. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna export that at ProRes, and keep that as my master backup by making a ProRes copy of just the time lapse that I've already edited. At 4x3, it gives me the option to crop and do all that stuff in the future if I wanted to. In order to export this ProRes, File, Export. Most of the time, this will be a H.264 for you guys, so go to QuickTime. We're gonna go to this video codec right here, Apple ProRes 422, hit match source. Now we have 3680 by 2760, which is what it's supposed to be. We do not need audio. Click here and make sure it saves to where I want it to. Save, export. Now I'm going to drag that in. Right here, you can see it's timelapse-1 period JPEG, and then timelapse.1 period .mov. Now this .mov is the ProRes version. That's the actual video clip. This is the time-lapse that Premiere has put together. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna get rid of these. I'm gonna use just this ProRes version because it's gonna be less CPU intensive to use that video file as opposed to the computer trying to process all of those photos whenever you're playing stuff back. Look at that. Austria, man. It's a beautiful place. So now we're in 4x3, which is not good for video. Next thing we want to do is, depends on what you want. If you want a 1920x1080 sequence, then go ahead. But because these are photos, you could probably fit them inside of 4K, which is 3840x2160. Change the previews. Yes. All right, so now we have the 16x9. Scale this up. Because you're in 4x3, you can do something like this. You can take the position and move it up with a keyframe. So now it slowly moves up as the video plays. We highlight this, export, and I will do YouTube 4K. And again, I don't need audio with this. Go here and then call this time-lapse 4K, export. So there you have it. My workflow for GoPro time lapses within Premiere Pro and Lightroom. Just know that the big key here is you color your material in Lightroom, you export either JPEGs or PNGs, and then you bring those into Premiere. You export one ProRes file that you keep as your backup and you use that whenever you need to. And if you guys have some other way of doing things, let me know down in the comments if you liked or if you disliked this video. I hope it was helpful for you. I hope you like my raps. Leave me a comment down below on something else that you want to see a tutorial about, and I will get to it. Thank you guys so much for watching if you made it this far, and I will see you guys on the next one.